Hello everyone. So in today's lecture, we'll be continuing with our aim offsets for our flashlight first, okay? And then if we have time, we'll also finish off with our weapon aim offset as well, okay? So the first thing is to get the aim offset files, okay? So I'll have this link in my description, okay? So get these files, okay? These are for the flashlight, okay? So I'll also migrate all of this FBX, okay? Into my game over here. Set flashlight, yeah, I'll just get all of the six ones. And the skeleton will be our SK mannequin skeleton that we have, and import all, okay? So all of these should be like this without any issues. And till now we are using a 1D aim offset, but now we will be using the actual just the normal aim offset, okay? So it has the both the yaw and the pitch, okay? So again, we'll be using the UE4 SK mannequin. So I'll call this AM_flash because we already have for the flashlight, okay? So from here, we also require the aim offset UE4. And we'll go into the documentation. So this is a 4.27, it's similar, the 5 is similar. So we'll go below. And from here, we will see that the first thing you have to do is select all of them and make them to mesh space and have to select the animation frame. So we'll go ahead and do that as well with the ones that you just have imported, okay? So asset actions, right click on them and then go to asset actions and bulk edit via property matrix and go to additive, okay? Make them to mesh space. And this one will be selected animation frame, and the pose selection will be the flashlight one. Make sure it's the Unreal Engine 4 one, okay? And then save all files and save all. So now from here, what we'll have to do is the CC will be the middle one. Actually, like delete this first. We'll come here on the details panel, asset details and axis settings. The horizontal axis, if you go back and scroll down a bit, you will see the first horizontal one is the yaw. So this will be our yaw, and this will be from minus 90 to 90. Smoothing 0.1. Actually make it to 0, yeah, and the other one would be the pitch, okay? So from minus 9, sorry, not minus 9, it will be minus 90 to positive 90. And make sure you have snap to grid and wrap input for both of these to true, okay? So middle would be the center, CD would be the down, CU is the upper one. So that this is the up one, this is the down. Left center will be left center, left down. Actually, I think there's, yeah, this, okay, I have made some mistake with this, so don't use the left center. So just use the left up and the left down, okay? Use the right center, right down and right up, okay? Left center, you could actually make it over here, so the hand is a bit to the center over here. Yeah, this is fine. Okay, make sure the left center is over here, and this is complete. Actually save this, close it out, and let's go to our hover folder animation and open up the ABP player, and we'll go to the anim graph, and over here we have the aim offset flashlight. So we'll delete this and change it with the aim offset flash. Now you can see over here we require both the pitch and the yaw. So the pitch will go in the pitch, but the yaw, we require the yaw, and there is a way over here that's written for the requirement for the yaw, but we won't use that because that this example is for a third person one, but since we are working with the first person, we already have the yaw total that actually gives us the yaw of the character, and that's why we'll be using this. Okay, and this yaw would be inversed if I'm not wrong, because right was minus 90, right? So it should be positive. So let's check it out with our flashlight. Now I'm here, let's come in front. Now let's move to the right. You can see the hand moves to the right and to the left. See, the hand moves to the left, below, up. See, so this is what we want. That is the lowest it will go. So it's working now again, and once I go off to the limit, it will actually, my character will actually swap and it will face in front. See, so this is good. So let's come to the big wall over here and see over here, turn around like this. See, so this is good. So the only issue is now this animation montage that is being played by our character, the shadow is not playing it, right? So we'll go to the third person character here and we will make a copy of this, paste it here, and for this we'll actually have to add the shadow mesh, right? Over here like this. So now if I'm to play, I get this and press F and go over here so I can see it properly, right? Now you can see even my shadow is playing the montage, so which is good. So this is perfect, right? So with this one done, let us move towards our gun as well, right? Rifle. Aim montage, not sorry, aim offset. So we have already got our skeletal meshes. We have a pistol. Actually, like our pistol isn't getting set yet. So what we'll do is, let's open up the base file and it has the gun, okay, and destroys it. So we'll come over here in the initialization, we have add inventory, and then we'll go over here and add the weapon as well, right? So before that, okay, and we'll actually be upgrading this inventory where we are actually manually doing it over here. We'll have it set to automatic in a while. You'll understand how that is done. Okay. And for now, let's go to our animation blueprint, because this is where we have our idle, turn left, locomotion, main states. Yeah. So locomotion. So from here, it's our idle. And from here, we will have another state, and this one will be idle gun state, right? So this will be depending on if we are actually holding the gun or not, and this one will be okay. So action is where our flashlight is, right? Turn on flashlight, has flashlight, using flashlight. So we have the using flashlight. So I'll have another one. This will be using gun, right? So If I am already using a flashlight, a gun will be set to false. Okay. And let us go back to the action part over here, and we'll have or add the input over here, and this will be pistol, and this one will be, let's say, one. We'll get this, and now this is turn on flashlight, and this is a custom event, I guess. Yeah, it's a custom event on the flashlight graph. So we'll have a gun graph, a pistol graph, and over here we'll have a custom event. This will be toggle gun, and this will be similar. So this will have a key similar to that. And let me check. This is just a key. And we'll be using almost the same thing over here. Has flashlight, we'll be changing it with has gun from our inventory. Has gun. So if has gun, we will be using, sorry, there will be a flip flop like the flashlight graph. Okay. So we'll have a flip flop here. So by default, we will set it to true the first time, and the second time we'll be setting it to false. And then over here we are actually playing the montage and then setting it to true and false. But right now we won't do that for our gun or pistol. Okay, we'll just be setting it to false and true and false, sorry. Yeah. And in our, we'll go to our ABP player, and in the event graph we'll have something similar over here using gun, and we'll promote this to a variable and connect it like this. Okay, and now idle to gun will be if using gun is true, and it will go back to idle if using gun is false. Okay, that is not Boolean. Okay. And over here, like I said, we already had the blend spaces from the animation startup pack. This was the jog for our, we'll get the direction and the speed over here like this. So if I have this, okay, I press one. You can see there's no difference at all. So let's see. The problem is in the action, we did not actually call the toggle gun, right? The key will be this one. So let's play again in our viewport. Toggle this one, and now you can see it's is running actually. That is not correct. So let's go to BS jog. This is 0, right? This is 0. And how are we setting this one up? Let's see. Idle walk. This is 0. 175, 475. So the speed is from 0 to, and the direction is 185 to 180, minus 185 to positive 185. Right. Yeah, this is fine. So the problem is over here. Walk run direction and ground speed. So what we have to check is what is our ground speed. So print this one out, have it like this. This one, I'm still at 0, but our character seems to be running around, which isn't good at all. And this is because it's moving from idle to this. Possibly, shouldn't be an issue. Okay, so this one is jog forward. Okay, by default it is jog forward. That's why. Why is it jog forward? We have the idle rifle hip and this one. Right click. Idle. Rifle hip. And let's see. Press 1. Is standing still. Walking, this is fine. Jog. The animations are not that great, but this is the best we can do. And since we are using a pistol, it's better not to use this yet. So for the gun, what we'll be doing is not be using that, but poses by bull. So this one would be false. Using gun is idle and rifle. Not rifle. Sorry. Pistol. So let's see this one first. So this is how the aim is. Yeah, so we have idle pistol like this at all given time, so we only have only one animation for the pistol, so we'll try to make most of it, to be honest. And let's see for the pistol. Yeah, that's the problem. Like for the pistol, we do not have the aim offsets. Okay. So again, I will try to create an aim offset with this, but I'll try, but I'm not sure it will look very good with the with this animation that we have. Okay. Why is this idle one? Okay, so for the mannequin, it doesn't actually doesn't mess up a lot, but for our character, it does mess up the hand a bit, which is unfortunate, but I don't think we can do something about this. Okay, so the next thing that we can do right now is over here, the walk run part. So what will I'll do is, layered blend per bone. We have used this before, okay? We'll use it again. And blend pose, this is the base pose. And the blend would be the pistol one like this. And from here we will have it like this, and again let's go ahead, bones, bone names, and spine underscore 01 01, and I'll check something from this one. We had a blend depth of 1 for the upper arm, but for this one, I am not sure. We'll have to check. So let's go ahead and check it. Yeah, this is kind of working. So yeah, this is kind of working. So after this, we'll do a blend pose by bull. So this would be the true one, and for the false it will be just direct. Using gun is the condition for our walk run. So let's test it again. This is the normal walking. I take the gun, I press 1, and I'm walking like this, which is correct. And yeah, the last time I actually lowered this camera, so you'll actually have to make it a bit above like this. Yeah, the camera should have to be a bit above this, I guess, like such, for the eye to match. Yeah, this is where my eye should be, and this is the perfect match. Yeah, so the plane per bone, so this one should be 5, I guess. Let's see. All hierarchy, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 maybe, or something. 4, let's see. 4. Yeah, this way is a bit too much on this side, particularly. This side, not too much, but this side, it's way too much. So, I'll play with this number and I'll tell you what is the best, okay? So this blend depth will be 5. And the other thing that I forgot was mesh space rotation blend should be set to true, okay? So, with that one now let's play again. And now, even if I'm moving like this, you can see my hand is to the point where I am actually looking. Like this, see? But this is fine. Yeah, this is fine, okay? So the aim offset is what we will require for the pistol to work as well, but I don't know how well I can manage this one out, okay? So we'll see, okay? So the next part is to add the gun in our hand, and like I said, we'll do it a bit dynamically, okay? And for that reason, I will first create the, I think on the hand R, we already have a weapon, right? Yeah, we already do, but I'll still create a new one and I'll call this the pistol one. And over here, we will add a skeletal mesh like this. Okay, pause the animation a bit, make it to 19, add it on the gun, add it on the hand properly, like such. Pistol does not actually properly go into the hand, like as you can see. This one is a bit off, or maybe it's too big for the hand. I think it's a bit too much for the hand, but it's fine. Like, this is the only animation I can use, so we'll just make do of whatever we have, right? Okay, and we will be coming here. We will spawn actor from class. And actually, we can do this, or I'll just keep it as a skeletal mesh over here that will be hidden. Okay, this will go under inventory again. This will be called the gun, and it will be hidden in game. And this one will be attaching it. The target variant would be the mesh. This one. And this is the pistol one. Okay. So again, from here, we will also set the set hidden in game. New hidden will be false, and this one will be true. Yes, so let's go ahead, pick it up, press 1. And you can see it's not working. Hidden in game is true. This one is set to false. Okay, let's set it to like this. Make sure it's always with us. And you can see it's not actually. So let's go to the viewport. The gun, yeah, because that's the reason. Hidden in game. To true. I forgot to use the pistol skeleton over here like this. So go to the code over here, set them like this again, and we can test it out. Press 1, there's the gun. It doesn't look that good, right? So we'll have to fix this somehow and make sure it looks at least it looks half decent at least. For some reason, I think this has to be like this. And this doesn't make sense. Why is it down? This is the only way that this gun will fit. The hand, see? But I don't know why it's like that. I'll just make it in front so it doesn't look that bad. Like this, see? It looks better than before at least. Right, another thing would be done that. Make it like this. Oops. Is it a bit too much? That rotation over there. Yeah, a bit too much rotation over there. This one seems fine. Okay, yeah, this is fine for now. In our next lecture, we'll try to actually do the aim offset for the pistol. Okay, so thank you guys, and I will see you in the next one.